Hello and welcome to a new SolidSteel parametric for SolidWorks video. The topic today is ribs. Let's get right into it. Here in this column we want to insert some ribs. To do that, of course, we are going to use the ribs tool. Ribs in general are very simple parts and the rib tool is easy to use. First we select in which profile the rib should be inserted and we immediately see a preview. To position the rib there are several possibilities. For example, I can enter a distance here that is based on the beginning of the profile, which is at the bottom of this profile here. More likely though, we want to place ribs based on components that are already in place. To do that, we can select edges as a reference. For example, this one. As we can see, the rib in the preview then also aligns itself directly to the selected edge. Looks pretty good from this view, but let's take a look at the backside of the column. A rib was also placed here as well because the default setting of the tool is both sides. This is usually correct, but here it makes no sense. To change this, simply select the option single-sided. And the wrong rib disappears. I think this is called the demonstration effect. No problem, one click on switch side and the rib is on the right side. It already looks good, but it's not perfect yet. We have selected the reference edge, but if we look closely, we see that the rib has been placed above it. Of course, we can easily influence this via the menu. Clicking on center does exactly what we would expect, but the rib aligns even nicer if it's exactly in line with the top of the flange. A click on change reference edge and everything fits exactly. Here below we can edit the thickness of the rib. Let's choose 20 mm, that suits better for the rather large profiles. Before confirming, we pin the menu. This way the next rib can be defined faster because SolidSteel remembers the previous settings as long as the menu remains open. Okay, the first rib is done. To place the second one, just select the profile again and the reference edge. As just mentioned and visible in the preview, all previous settings have been applied. Of course, this also means that the placement is below the reference edge. But this is no problem. To align the rib correctly, we just have to switch off the option switch reference edge again. Now everything is the way we want it and we could just confirm the rib. But I won't do that yet because I'll use this opportunity to show a few more features of the rib tool. It could be, for example, that we only want to have a half rib. We can achieve this by simply clicking on partial. Here on the outside of the column the rib is not of much use. A quick click on flip side and the rib is placed well. Another option would be to slant partial, which is often done in areas where the support structure is visible. Looks good and is turned on and off with a click. Just as easily the corners of the rib are affected. For example, we can simply select a bore instead of a chamfer. Or even have the rib follow the contour of the profile. I'll switch back to the chamfer so it matches the rib already placed and confirm. Okay, now we should have seen pretty much all the usual options for placing ribs. But now let's take a look at one more detail that can be influenced by the general settings. To do this, let's switch to the top view. If we zoom in close to the rib, we see that there is a small gap all around it. This gap has no meaning in the pure drawing, but it's important on the later construction side to compensate for tolerances in the components. In the menu settings, under tolerances, we find the setting rib base tolerance. In my case, the value is now set so that the rib is 1 mm smaller all around. But of course, everyone can define this the way they want. Okay, so much for the ribs tool. I hope you found the video interesting or useful. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to show it with a like or by subscribing to the channel. For more info on SolidSteel parametric for SolidWorks, check out the other videos or our website. See you next time!